Bad news for Tesla enthusiasts and fans, as the much-anticipated Tesla FSD rollout has been plagued with a series of issues that has threatened the rollout of the products. These challenges are quite unusual, as Tesla is known for producing quality products, but the FSD failure has turned out to be the worst product rolled out by Tesla thus far, as it continues to suffer more and more setbacks. Find out in this video how the FSD rollout for Tesla has been disappointing and how it is affecting Tesla. Hi guys, welcome back to Glancy Tech, where we take you through all you need to know about Tesla FSD flaws. Tesla is a world leader when it comes to the development of electric cars. The company is currently the most valued automobile company in the world, ahead of Ford, GM, and other market competitors. The company has grown since its establishment in 2003, overtaking many established companies to top the list of most valuable automobile companies in the world. The company was the first automobile brand to reach a $1 trillion market cap, a feat no other automobile brand has ever come near to date. It just seems as Tesla is destined for success. Driving the surge in Tesla value has been its electric car brand, which has increasingly gained more attention as more and more people seek to transition to clean energy, which is much needed at this point. In addition to the production of electric cars, Tesla vehicles have some autonomous features which were designed to make driving a lot easier. This feature is known as Tesla's Full Self-Driving, or FSD. It is one of the distinguishing features of the Tesla brand. Tesla's FSD Beta allows the car driver to choose from three driving profiles. These driving profiles dictate to a large extent how the car will react to certain situations on the road. The modes include Chill, Average, and Assertive. What differentiates these modes is the degree of aggressiveness, which varies remarkably. The feature was included in the October 2021 version 10.3 update. Tesla's FSD software is offered as a one-time purchase, currently priced as $12,000, or as a subscription for $199 each month. Unfortunately, not every FSD customer or subscriber gets to use these advanced self-driving features. Tesla calculates a safety score based on driving metrics from the recent past. If the score indicates that the driver isn't paying close enough attention to the road or is driving too aggressively, FSD use will not be allowed, despite paying for the feature. Even after qualifying and using FSD, it can be taken away if the driver's safety scores fall. But the rollout of these features have faced obstacles since it was debuted. And as a matter of fact, the rollout of these products has not been successful thus far due to cases of accidents involving the vehicle. Tesla recently issued a swift rollback of its Full Self-Driving Beta software after it was harshly criticized by drivers who received it via an over-the-air update. Now, the automaker has sent out a formal recall with the National Highway Traffic Safety Administration over the matter. The problem first began on October 23, 2021, after its initial rollout of the update, which was sent to vehicles enrolled in Tesla's FSD Beta, a program which, despite its name, is not an autonomous driving system. According to the notice filed with the NHTSA, this initially affected 11,704 vehicles across Tesla's lineup, including models S, X, 3, and Y. Vehicles recalled were all running software 2021.36.5.2, better known as FSD Beta 10.3. Tesla doesn't explicitly identify the software as FSD Beta 10.3 in the recall notes, though it does acknowledge that the software was only pushed to vehicles enrolled in the Full Self-Driving Beta. The recall was related to user experts, which have not been pleasant for most drivers. Some drivers experience constant phantom emergency braking, even when maintaining a safe following distance behind other vehicles. The update was referred to online as bad, broken, jank, terrifying, and almost undrivable. The problem associated with the FSD was present in vehicles waking up from sentry mode and summon standby mode, both of which cause an onboard chip to enter a low power state. This, according to Tesla, caused an unexpected communication disconnection, which consequently caused a series of inconsistencies in detected object velocity. The vehicles then displayed false forward collision warnings, and some engaged the vehicle's automatic emergency braking procedure. Meanwhile, Tesla is already under the NHTSA's watchful eye over a separate OTA update. The federal regulatory body launched a probe into Tesla earlier in late 2021. This was related to the update also, which was sent out. The update was expected to make Tesla vehicles easily identify stationary emergency vehicles. But, unfortunately, it resulted in about 11 collisions, which thankfully did not result in the loss of lives and properties, but caused some minor injuries to the driver. The vehicles collided with fire trucks and police cruisers while it was on autopilot. According to the NHTSA, the first victim to report the FSD beta failure was an unidentified customer living in Brea, California, with a Tesla Model Y RWD. According to the report published on the NHTSA website, the car sounded a warning. However, it was halfway through the turn. The driver tried to steer the vehicle back to the correct lane, but the car would have taken control and forced itself into the incorrect lane, creating an unsafe maneuver and putting everyone involved at risk. Before this period, Tesla and the NHTSA have had issues with the safety of the FSD. The head of the National Transportation Safety Board already expressed serious concerns about the safety of the Tesla FSD during the initial rollout. But Tesla ignored this warning and decided to go ahead with the rollout. Tesla even expanded its use as the company enabled access to the beta version of its full self-driving program to more Tesla drivers via a request button on Tesla's dashboard screens. However, before a driver gets access to the software, Tesla claims to have a mechanism to regulate its use. Using the safety score, which will determine the likelihood for a driver to crash his or her car, the safety score is based on 5 criteria, according to Tesla. Even at this, Jennifer Holmendy, chair of the National Transportation Safety Board, was buying into the safety mechanism as she wasn't convinced enough of the capabilities of the system. And so, it's not surprising to see the whole process turn out into a mess for Tesla. As a result of this mess, Tesla would have to recall over 53,822 vehicles in the U.S. due to a feature in its FSD software that prevents them from coming to a full stop at intersections. The rolling stop functionality enables drivers to drive past traffic intersections at slow speeds, ranging from 5 to 6 miles per hour. The recall puts the FSD under the spotlight, testing the claims and the safety of the FSD functionality, which is still in beta testing mode. The interesting thing is, from a few thousand at the beginning of September last year, FSD has garnered more than 60,000 users, as the company reported in its latest earnings call. It is a part of a suite of software services that are expected to drive Tesla's future revenue growth. Despite these challenges, Elon Musk, the CEO of Tesla, is still adamant that the FSD would work. Interestingly, Mr. Musk expects the technology to drive sales of the existing fleet of Tesla vehicles. When he was asked about the company's strategy to achieve 3 million vehicles in sales by 2024 without the introduction of new models, Musk said that the gravity of FSD was underappreciated, meaning the functionality will attract more buyers to the company's existing vehicle fleet. But with the way things are going, the issues of accidents and the like, it looks impossible, but you never can rule out the multi-talented entrepreneur who has led Tesla to this point. Obviously, if Tesla was going to come out of this, it has to find a lasting solution to this problem. But considering the issues already on the ground with the NHTSA and the recall, it seems as if Tesla might have to suspend the rollout of its FSD products temporarily till they find a lasting solution. The news of the recalls has already affected Tesla shares as the company grappled with the reports of the issue. If this persists, the ambitious goal of 4 million sales of electric vehicles could be affected. Tesla might have to keep battling with this, but what do you think? Have you tried the FSD feature of any Tesla model before? Share your thoughts with us, and if you trust Elon Musk to finally fix these issues. Let's get your responses in the comment section, and that'll be all for today. If you found this video interesting and enlightening, do well to subscribe to Glancy Tech for more updates.